It's party time, Mom. Welcome to another episode of the Chad Prather Show here in the Mothership, which is Studio 22. We're going to dig into your brains today, and it's going to be fun with the Puppet Master, Mark, and Candice, the Queen of the Ethiopians. When y'all get married, y'all are going to have little Tate Turtots. I love it. I wish I could take credit for that, but that's a Natalie. That is a hot news Natalie sitting over there at the pub.
Well, then Steve made it even longer.
What did you say? Tateritas?
Tater Totteritas.
Tater Totteritas. Oh,
that's
my
funny.
Gosh. I love my multiracial couple. Oh, God bless them. I mean, there's not multi, just two. Yeah, we still don't know what Candace is. But that's okay. She's a lovely human being, and that's all right with me. It's all right with me. She just glows. Lisa Page, host of Lisa Page Made Me Do It. How are you, first off?
I'm feeling fantastic since I have my new hoodie here.
Yeah. We keep it cold in here.
It's so cold, but not me.
Yeah, we keep it cold in here. Don't put that hood on.
Why?
That's it.
Oh, girl. You about to drop. You about to start dropping shells.
What's the matter? What's up?
Is that controversial?
You gotta hold your gun sideways. You can't hit shit, right. But it looks cool.
What's up,
son? You're gonna get shot in the leg, yeah. All right?
Bam!
What? Officer, you said to get back in the car. Boom!
Damn, oh, no. That was that
wow.
Straight up.
Oh, no.
Oh, Officer Petrovich, we don't mean that at all.
Not at all.
No. All right, that's what happened with you were coming to work, well, you were coming to the studio the other day.
Yeah, yesterday.
And you were doing, what, 25 over? Something
29
like that?
Over.
I had to go to the bathroom.
According to the
How
ticket.
Fast?
He's going to jail.
How yeah. fast, Steve?
29 over according
29.
To the ticket.
What is the speed limit, Natalie, on the road? 35?
30.
30. I was going like 59.
Girl.
I had to go to the bathroom.
You are going 50, so you're admitting.
I already have a ticket, so it's whatever.
Yeah.
I just
admitted you're not supposed to admit to anything.
Well, I did as he came right up to my
Steve
window.
Steve will call you out on television.
Yeah, come on. Dang. So much for promoting this hoodie.
That's like when I gave those pecker pills to Aubrey Huff on our show, and Steve goes, well, Chad just committed a felony right here on television. And I was like, I was showing him the Get Roman stuff. I was showing him what it looks like.
I was just making jokes, and I didn't even think that
I understand.
A real law. So.
People are like, oh, well, a felony for Chad Prather. What could we were looking for something to get him on. And, oh, my gosh.
Mm.
You sold your house yet, Natalie?
Yes.
Yeah, well, you better get it done before Joe Biden takes
yeah,
over.
Yeah, that's right.
You won't get anything done, girl.
That money, girl.
Capital gains tax.
Get that money in. You better hide it. You better hide it fast.
Yeah, we listed it on Friday.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She gone.
She gone.
Natalie, it's white privilege. You sold your house because of white privilege.
We got my buddy Ron White here in the hot seat with us today. We're going to have some fun. Have a lot of fun. Thanks for being here. We were showing, you know, I told everybody yesterday that you sent me the video, and you and I have hung out, and it's always fun being around you because your memory is so dadgum great. I mean, just incredible. And you sent me the video that had the first 100 episode titles of the Chad Prather Show that was on the Blaze. And I was like, dadgum. And we're watching it. And the president of the network is sitting there watching it with us. And he goes, I know that guy. He's on Brain Games. And I was like, exactly.
Yeah.
Like, that's pretty in tune for him to, you know, that he remembered you doing that. So, golly, dude, we're going to have fun today.
Yeah, no, it is. But, you know, it's a system. I appreciate all the accolades I get from my memory, but it's work. It's a system, and anybody can do it.
It's work.
It is work.
That's the impressive part of it.
Yeah.
Is the work that goes into it. We're going to get into that deal. Before we do, hey, have you noticed your hair isn't looking as full as it used to? I know. Losing your hair sucks. So I'm going to give you some options. You can go to the doctor and talk about hair loss treatment and get a prescription from him or her. Then you can visit the pharmacy and try not to go broke just to avoid going bald. Or you can try Keeps from the comfort of your own home. You're going to get the same doctor-recommended FDA-approved hair loss treatment, but Keeps offers the generic versions at about half the cost. And one more thing you'll love about Keeps, it's all online. You just answer a few questions, you snap a couple of pictures of your hair, and a licensed doctor is going to review your info, recommend the right hair loss treatment for you, and then it's going to be shipped directly and discreetly to your door. So why make unnecessary trips to the doctor and the drugstore when you can just do it all online at home? I'm going to get you started with a special deal. Go to keeps.com, keeps.com/loss. For 50% off your first order of Keeps hair loss treatments, that's keeps.com/loss. Go there today. We'll be right back.
Hey,
All right. So those of you over at the pub, would you consider yourselves as having a good memory?
No.
No. I have CRS.
Yeah?
Yep.
Can't remember shit. Can't remember shit.
I can remember when I was a kid, all different types of things when I was a kid, younger, but I can't remember. I hardly know him.
Yeah.
Well, certain things you block out, maybe.
Yeah, there's a, like, I can remember, like, growing up and you knew your best friend's phone numbers. I remember all my friends' phone numbers.
Yeah. Right.
I remember a lot of that. I can remember my late grandparents' phone number. I can remember my parents' old phone number at their house. Of course, I had it most of my life. It's my same phone number. But it's weird, the older you get, do you find this true? The older you get, like you either doubt or like I know that person told me their name, but do I remember? I'm pretty good with names because I try to say their name immediately in a conversation.
Right.
Or repeat it right back to them. And I've always done pretty good with the waiters, the waitresses, the people, you know, wherever you go. The people, because it means something to me to do that, because, I mean, people are important.
And you've taught me that over the last few years of, that's it. Before I would meet somebody, I wouldn't.
Because you think you're
later,
better than all of them,
forget
Steve.
Yeah, a little bit. They remember mine.
Yeah, exactly. That's all that really
yeah,
truly
that's
matters.
All that really matters.
Why do I want to remember that piece of shit's name? I know, but I find myself sometimes like people whose names that I know just as well as my own, and all of a sudden I draw a blank.
Right.
I'm like, that disturbs me. So I think it's critical that not only you read. That's my philosophy. You have to read, and I do that a lot. But you need to work on these brain games, so to speak. Do you feel like that's true? Or, I mean, you got a steel trap up there.
Well, no, I know it's true. I took a memory seminar when I was 18 years old. I was kicked out of the University of North Texas at a 0.9 GPA. I had this theory I could just show up, take the test, whatever.
Yeah.
It didn't work. But during that suspension, I took a memory course. So, and then I just started doing it for a living. So it's been 30 years. And here's the point I'm getting at. When I first started, I would go into a room and I'd memorize 100 or 150 names, introduce myself, and then go back and rattle off everybody's name. I can still do that today, but 30 years later, at the age of almost 48, it's slowing down. My processing speed is slowing down, and I can feel it. I can sense it, and that's true. After about age 35, all our processing speed slows down.
Yeah.
It's just, it's life.
It's scary. It sucks. Like, I went to sleep last night thinking, I may wake up dead. Like I'm at that point in my life.
What are you doing?
Just laying there. But at my age, I can still masturbate, but it gives me heartburn. You know what I'm saying?
Or you just get bored. And you're like, oh,
yeah, it's like,
man,
you roll over, throw your back out. Like, I'm gonna have sex. No, I'm not. I'm over it. Talk myself out right out of that.
Right.
But it is because I'm almost 48 too, and so I feel that. And sometimes I look at myself and I'm like, God, I'm almost Steve's age. You know, I'm almost Party Foul's age.
You almost are.
I'm almost half 100.
You're catching me.
Yeah.
I hope you don't.
And, well, I hope I don't either.
I hope you. I don't know. I hope you do, but you don't.
Yeah, but I hope you stay 2 years ahead of me.
Yeah, right.
But like, I can remember going back, and when I was in college, we had. Certain tests, we had certain professors that they would give you an outline, right, of everything that was in a book. And basically, you had to be able to go back in and regurgitate the outline, which was a stupid test. Stupid test. All the points, the subpoints, and everything. And that was the whole deal. So you just spent your time not necessarily learning anything. You were just, it was a rote memory thing. And I can remember going in and say, when I went and got my master's degree, I was taking classes in Koine Greek, which is what the New Testament was written in, and I was that the memory thing came in handy there. And then, I can remember saying, "Okay, well, I want to learn the entire book of John in the New Testament. In the beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God. He was all things. You know, without Him, nothing was made that was made. With, you know, just going on. In Him was light. Light was the light of men. And light shines the darkness. Darkness didn't comprehend it." There was a man.
So, are you reviewing? You're not reviewing this every day in your brain.
No, no,
you
no,
still
no.
know it.
I mean, I still
know
it. This is college. This is 20 years ago. So, you know, there was a man sent from God. His name was John. He was not the light, but was sent to bear witness of that light.
You know the Greek alphabet too, though, right?
Alpha, beta, gamma, delta, epsilon, zeta, theta, iota, kappa, lambda, mu, nu, xi, omicron, pi, rho, sigma, tau, epsilon, phi, kappa, psi, omega.
Bless you.
So stuff like that. That's rote, right? I remember those things. And I have a Greek professor who used to say all the time, he's like, one of these days you're just going to be slumped over in a wheelchair in a nursing home by yourself going, alpha, beta, delta, gamma, alpha. But I, what we used to do is we used to go for, we'd go out for drinks in bars, and I'd find the fraternity guys. And I would say, if I could say the Greek alphabet faster than you, because, you know, that's the big thing for Greek,
right.
You know, the, in the Greek fraternity deal is the alphabet. So if I can say it faster than you, you got to buy the drinks. Nah, you'll never be able to do that. Let's try it. And so we would do things like that. Or we would, I'd say, I'll tell you what, let's light a match. And if it burns down to your buddy's lips before you say the Greek alphabet.
Oh, wow.
It, you know, then we'd make all kind of challenges and stuff like that. We drink a lot for free. You know what I'm saying? But I was impressed because.
Which helps your memory, of course.
Exactly. 100%. It's amazing the things you do remember as well as forget
right.
When you're drinking. But the, and that's always been the kind of the thing for me. Like I used to memorize stuff like Shakespeare and just, and because you're always on your Instagram, which is fun, and everybody should be following you on Instagram, is you're constantly putting up your daily writings of, you know, different old philosophers and stuff like that. You know, you got to love Epictetus.
Right. Well, now I know how to pronounce his name. I know how to spell it, but I haven't known. I like Stoicism. I just like the philosophy of it, you know, of just being okay with life and okay with what happens. And so, yeah, I started putting that up there. And,
yeah. But, it's know, good stuff.
Yeah.
It's a great brand, right? I mean, just being able to do stuff like that and people have that, they know what to expect.
Right.
They're coming there, they're looking for that. And that's right. Good stuff. So, what we're going to do, we're going to do it in the next segment. We're going to talk a little bit more about it. In the next segment, you got a pocket constitution here.
Right, I do, yeah.
And you've memorized all of that.
Yeah, it's 4,543 words. I memorized it last year, and I traveled around, wrote it out on a wall, and then I forgot it because I didn't memorize it. And then all this stuff with a coronavirus started happening and the election. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to re-memorize the Constitution. This is the time to do it.
Yeah.
So I re-memorized it, and we're going to do a test that I've never, ever done before, but I think I can do it.
I'm sure you can.
I know I can.
Is there a different method for learning something for short term versus learning something for long term?
The methods are really the same, but the review is the difference. So you will remember something if today you give me a 50-digit number. I could repeat it right back. But if you ask me in 2 weeks, I wouldn't know it if I don't review.
Yeah,
the difference between short term and long term is going to be the review, spaced repetition.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I alluded to that, you know, my system with numbers was every digit had a word picture. Like,
right.
You know, let's say one was a banana and two was, for lack of, you know, a monkey.
Right.
And three was a tree. And so if it was 1, 2, 3, there was a banana being eaten by a monkey in a tree. And I could see that story in my head and I knew you by a story.
Right.
Like if I wanted to memorize your phone number, I knew you by a story. Hmm.
And that's exactly, people always say, I'm so good with faces, I never forget a face, but I can't remember the name. It's because you saw the face, you never saw the name.
Right.
So what you were doing was seeing the number. And that's really the trick of memory, the language of memory, seeing things as pictures. It's what I do with the Constitution. Yeah, it's how you
memorize. Crazy. Joe Biden should take a class.
Well, one of the memory books,
I
tried to read one, and that was one of the things, when you meet someone, you actually, in your mind, you draw their name on their forehead. So you can visualize their name on their forehead.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I draw it on their chest.
Whatever. So, you know, you see someone and you imagine yourself drawing it on their forehead. So you'll remember it. And that kind of worked. Then I forget about using that in everyday life.
And I don't know who suggested that, but I would take it a step further. And instead of seeing Lisa written out, I would see the Mona Lisa. See a picture instead of seeing written out. Because if you just see writing, I don't know if that's going to help so much, but it's the right track.
So my daughter, when I was single mom and she was 2, I wanted her to memorize my phone number.
Right.
And I taught her by a melody. So she'd go, 512 num.
You still have the same phone number?
I do. Yeah, so that's
it.
But then
the
I told her, you go up to
email me for her phone
officer,
number.
She'll sing it to you. Don't listen. And so when she was little, she would go up to these police officers and start singing my phone number. And I was single. I'm like, is he cute? So anyway, but yeah, she gave them all my phone number. And I didn't get a date from
the other day. The other day, talking about memory, and interestingly enough, somebody commented on the YouTube premiere. And it was 2 weeks ago or last Monday when I was by myself sitting at the bar and I did the deal on what's going on in America right now. And they said, where's the hot chick? And they were talking about you. And they're like, where's that hot chick? And I was like, you don't even remember her name.
Nope.
Don't even remember her
name.
No,
I get called hot news in the airport. Hot news! And I'm like, it's Natalie!
One of the reasons why I give people nicknames, okay?
Right.
I give people nicknames. I can remember Ron White because you got the comedian Ron White and you got, and of course, you know, but I got a personal relationship with the guy. And so, you know, I Lisa Page made me do it. Party Foul Steve, Candice the Queen of the Ethiopians, Puppet Master Mark, you know, Chance the Soulless Ginger Rapper, mm-hmm. Stu Bergier.
I know, boring.
Stu's got a good memory though, right?
Yeah, well, he's good with numbers and statistics, but not with names.
Yeah. Yeah.
Really bad with names.
He still doesn't know my name.
He still doesn't even know who Steve is. No one knows.
No. And they share the same name.
Share the same name.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah. Technically, they share this because Stu's real name
but
is Steven.
But I think half the time Stu forgets that his name is really Steven because nobody calls him Steven except for his mom.
Right.
So, no, literally nobody.
Yeah. Me too.
Well, I believe it was episode, let's see, 41, 42, 43, 44. He is smarter than the rest of us. Stu is smarter than the rest of us.
Yeah.
Isn't that right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right. Okay. We need to have Stu back on, maybe. Yeah. He is smart. Now, but I mean, listen, I'm happy to play the village idiot around here. It's perfectly good. Between Glenn Beck and Stu and Pat and, well, Jeffy's probably, yeah. But anyway, but in all seriousness, I love just kind of being the one that everybody gets mad at, and they send the messages down to Candace saying, tell Chad not to say mother.
And there it is.
And there it is. Sorry,
and
Kevin.
There it is. I just wanted to give you something to do today in editing. Write down the timestamp. We're going to get into this thing, man.
Yeah. You know, speaking of nicknames, you know who's good at nicknames? Donald Trump, Sleepy Joe,
exactly.
Biden. You know, I mean, you give the nicknames and they stick and they brand the person.
That's right.
And then you remember the nickname. Low Energy Jeb, right?
That's
you remember the nickname.
Lion Ted.
Lion Ted. That is, it's a good picture. It's a good memory cue. And he's great at it.
Yeah.
He's brilliant at it.
Have you ever noticed that?
Crooked Hillary.
Historically speaking, like, you didn't know the members of the cabinet, you didn't know the press secretary, you didn't know all these different people that were in the administration that were, but now you know, like, you hear these names all the time. These names are just popping up, they're thrown at you constantly, and there's all these people that you never cared about.
Thank you, social media.
But with social media and the advent of Donald Trump, you get a lot of that.
Yeah,
crazy
thing. He was a great memory coach. I'm going to be Joe Biden's memory coach. The one thing I hope, as a memory expert, what would be the worst thing that could happen? I get dementia. If I get dementia, I hope I get to go to the White House too.
Yeah. Okay?
Yes, that's right.
Joe Biden got dementia, and he goes to the White House, not the nursing home.
No, I know. But. I know. It's insane, dude. And there is no word. I mean, really. I say this with hyperbole, but there's also a lot of truth to it if you've ever lived through it. There's nothing worse than seeing somebody go through dementia or Alzheimer's.
It's sad. It's horrible. It's terrible.
And my father had dementia. My grandmother had Alzheimer's. Just horrible to watch a beautiful brain just deteriorate that way. And that's why I tell you guys, if that happens to me, just get rid of me. I can't stand it.
I got
in the coffin and then the
Steve is looking forward to the day, absolutely, when he gets the opportunity to do it. Well, we're going to get into this, so don't go anywhere. But, hey, next time you grill up a couple of steaks, I want you to pop open a bottle of Extreme Altitude Malbec wine. I'm loving this wine from Bonner Family Wines. It comes from a remote vineyard in Argentina up around 9,000 feet where the grapes grow. And when they aren't making wine, they're herding cattle. So they know meat, they know barbecue, and that's what these Malbecs are for. So pop open a bottle, and you're going to get blackberry, you're going to get leather, smoke, little dark cherry. You're also getting less sugar, less chemicals and additives, and 10 times more resveratrol. I never say that word right, I don't think, but hey, it's a powerful longevity booster, and you're going to love it. Good for your brain, folks. And guys, over at cowboywines.com, just got a special shipment of these wines in. They got one Malbec from the third highest vineyard in the world. It's 8,950 feet up in the sky. So visit cowboywines.com today. You're going to get 50% off wine, 50% off of shipping. It was a small shipment, so it's going to go fast. Visit cowboywines.com. Remember that, and we'll be right back. Yeah. Bucking Bulls are bucking in Fort Worth this weekend. That's right. World Finals. World Finals. Party Foul.
I'm there.
I think he's, well, I'm talking about the bull name party foul.
No, I'm,
you,
I'm going.
You can't go.
Why can I not go?
You have to be able to produce a COVID letter.
Oh, I can write him one.
That's the ridiculous. You can't go be around the bulls.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't want anybody around them that hasn't had one.
Well, it's not. Yeah. That's the whole deal. You got to be able to test negative and prove that you've tested negative.
Hopefully I can get another copy of it.
That's the whole deal. Make sure your microphones are on, guys.
Oh.
It's on.
Are they on?
Is mine on?
I'm so excited about this segment right here. So, listen, I'm a little nervous.
Well, me too.
All right? No. It's okay. Now, we did nothing. I have the little pocket constitution
what
here.
What if you stump him?
I don't want to do that.
Are you nervous, Ron?
I have an idea. You open a page, and I'll tell you how many lines to go down. Let her pick the page number, or because she's Lisa Page.
Okay. In that book, it's not. There's other things other than Constitution. So make sure
I'll make sure it's the Constitution.
It's the front of the book. Oh, it's like the first 16 pages.
Trust me.
Pocket Constitution. We all need one.
Declaration of Independence. I don't got
something.
Yeah. We're going to stick with the Constitution. I know it. Okay, I know when I'm reading the Constitution. you guys have this book's pretty much full of it, full of the Constitution. People don't know the Constitution. That's right. One of the things. We'll just say that, and that's why this is so important.
That's why I wanted to do it. I got sick of people saying, that's unconstitutional. Yeah. is it really unconstitutional? What part are you talking about right now?
Exactly.
What article? Yeah. What section are you specific? Well, I don't know, but it doesn't feel American. It's unconstitutional. Yeah.
That's exactly right.
Is it really unconstitutional? And that's why I wanted to memorize it.
Yeah.
You know what they say. They.
Right.
Well, it's unconstitutional according to who, they say it.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
CNN says it, so it must be wrong.
Right.
Exactly. Exactly. So, all right, let's start simple, okay?
Yeah.
Here we go. You ready, Ron?
Ron's nervous.
The best. Well, I got it. So, if you could say a few sentences and then know where you're at, then I'll say stop and I'll take it from there.
All right.
But I got to figure out where
you're
at.
Okay,
that's what we're going to do.
Go.
Okay.
Visualize, Ron. Yeah.
Very simple. We're going to start with what everybody should know at least.
Okay.
All right. We, the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union,
establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America.
All right. Very good. That's a good start. When you got the preamble to the Constitution.
That's an easy one, though. That's starting him off easy.
Let's see. Please, party mouth, Steve.
Steve, can you do it?
Thank you. No,
I can't at all.
Exactly. It's not that easy. That was solid. That was solid. All right. So, here we go. Before I get over here to you guys, and y'all get to pick some pages. The seats of the senators of the first class shall be vacated at the expiration of the second year.
Of the second class at the expiration of the fourth year, and of the third class at the expiration of the sixth year, so that one third may be chosen every second year. And if vacancies happen by any reason if vacancies happen by resignation or otherwise during the recess of the legislature of the Senate, the executive authority thereof, and then it goes on to talk about making temporary appointments.
Right on. All right on. What you know about that?
That was so good.
I might have flipped one or two words there, but that's the general.
But you corrected yourself on the one, and you said Senate instead of state, but that's okay. That's okay.
But again, Ron, the average person wouldn't know because nobody knows. You're the only one.
Nobody knows about the third seat, the sixth.
You could at least shut somebody up in a conversation really quick.
Totally. Yes.
I love it when people say, can you quote it? Well, as a matter of fact.
Yes.
Let me tell you about the third seat in the Senate.
It is hard to work into conversations, though.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. I love it, dude. That's fun. All right. Pick a page.
Between what number?
We're going to pick 16? A page between, it'll be the Constitution. It'll be page one of the Constitution. And page...
Well, that's the Declaration of Independence and the Amendment. So the Constitution goes to about page 16 or something.
There it is. Hang on.
Pick something in the middle.
There
what
it
if,
is.
What if we started you...
one and 15.
What if we started you with,
I've got the amendments to the Constitution.
But in all. I know the amendments, but I didn't memorize them word for word.
Hang on.
I got you.
If I just gave you, but in all.
No. Is that the one... is that in all such cases?
Yes! Okay. Oh, my God!
See?
That's
But yeah, but I don't know. Okay.
All right, give me a page number.
Okay, let's go to page 8. Page 8.
Okay. All right. How many lines down?
I want you to go 6 lines down and start reading there.
No, the word 9. The 9th word.
All right. Purchased by the consent of the legislature of the state in which the same shall be for the erection of forts,
magazines, articles, dockyards, and other needful buildings to make all laws which shall be necessary and proper for carrying forth into execution the foregoing powers and all powers vested by this Constitution in the government of the United States in any department or officer thereof. The immigration or importation of such persons as any of the states now existing shall think proper to admit shall not be prohibited prior to the year 1808.
What you know by that?
Hot diggity dog.
Was that right about
gosh.
That?
Yes. Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, a nuance here or there, but yeah.
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 Chad said erection.
I'm semi-chub right now. Yeah. I am semi-chub. No, I mean, that's most people. I mean, you could probably honestly count on 2 hands how many people on the planet, especially in the, you know, in the United States, mm-hmm. have said, I'm going to memorize. I know they're out there.
Mm-hmm.
They're out there, but very few people have done that.
Well, when I started doing it, people told me, oh, Ted Cruz did that, which, you know, is great. So I tried to research it, and what he did was a little different than what I did. Section 8 of Article 1, he had made a little acronym, I guess you would say. So he remembered the topics of mm-hmm. the sections, but not word for word.
Right.
And I got it 98% word for word. Sometimes I'll flip-flop felony or treason or the and then. But,
well, like you said, yeah. Immigration instead of migration.
Okay.
But I mean, that's okay. Good Lord.
Right.
You know.
So do you do this with like, have you done this with like books and stuff like the Bible or anything like that?
You know, like Chad, 28 years ago, I memorized the first 7 chapters of the book of Proverbs.
Wow.
That's impressive.
Yes.
That's hard to memorize.
So, but that's really the only book. I was after September 11th, I joined the military, and I served from 2002 to 2010, 2007. I was deployed to Afghanistan. So when I got back from Afghanistan, I was looking at the Vietnam War, and the idea just hit me. You know, I want to honor the guys that I served with that didn't make it back. So I memorized everybody who died in the war in Afghanistan in the order of their death. There's 2,400 of them, ranked first name, last name. It's 7,000 words. I'll travel around the United States with this wall. I've done it at NASCAR, MLB games, the Washington Monument. It takes me 10 hours to write out. It's like you're watching the Vietnam Wall get created, but it's Afghanistan.
Yeah.
And wow. From memory.
And you're writing it all out?
I write it out from memory, and every time I've done it, every single time I've done it, somebody will come up to me and they will say, he'll give me a name, is Daryl Lewis on the wall? And I'll say, yes, ma'am, he is. He's number 409. So I'll take her to number 409, and she'll look there. And I've done this 30 times, and every time it's happened. She'll look at Daryl Lewis's name, and she'll just start crying. And this happened in San Antonio, and I said, how do you know him? And she said, I'm his widow.
Wow.
I was in Maryland doing it, and he, you know, a guy is Kyle Van de Giesen on the wall. I said, yes, sir. I believe he was a captain, a helicopter pilot. He said, you're right. He was. I said, he's number 900 on the wall. I took him to number 900, and I said, how do you know him? He said, he's my son. Mm. So it happens every time, and it's
and
amazing.
And nothing more powerful. I mean, we said after 9/11, never forget.
Mm-hmm.
And what have we done? We've forgotten.
Yep.
Mm. Yeah.
Except for Ron.
Except for Ron.
Yeah.
But and it was evidenced 9/11. They didn't do the same reading of the names this year. There were so many things. Now defund the police has come along, and you know we've villainized so many of our first responders because we forgot.
Right.
Right. And that's what. There's no more powerful thing than making somebody's name so important that you remember it.
Well, you know, when we say you're not forgotten, and I think we do mean that, but we mean it as a whole, you are not forgotten.
Right.
And what I wanted to do is say, Captain Kyle Van de Giesen, you are not forgotten.
Yeah.
Private First Class Austin Staggs, you are not forgotten. First Lieutenant Timothy Steele, you are not forgotten. So I wanted to make it individual. You know, they say everybody dies 2 deaths, the time they die and the last time their name is spoken.
Spoken, yeah.
So, you know, moms and dads will stand at that wall and they will wait for 4 hours to get to their son's
amazing
name. It's just a way to keep their memory alive.
How long does it take you to do that?
It takes 10 or 11 hours to write it out. To write out amazing. The Constitution, it takes about 6 hours.
Amazing.
Yeah, that's incredible.
It's amazing. Let's pick another page.
Okay.
Let's pick another page.
This is like one of those things you love doing it because you get that rush of adrenaline, but there's also a little bit of rush of fear.
The pressure.
All right. Let's do another one that should be rather simple. And this goes over into the amendments.
Okay, so I know.
I bet you got this one.
Well, I know the topics of the amendments. Yeah. I don't know them word for word.
All right, I'm curious though. If I say to you a well-regulated militia being necessary,
the Second Amendment.
Yeah. So you know that. You know that it's the Second Amendment. But that and those and I can see where that starts to get. That's the most important thing is being able to know, which is kind of back to what you were saying. Ted Cruz did. You know where it is. You know where to find it.
Yeah, the amendments, I just know the topic. The freedom of speech, the right to bear arms. You don't have to quarter soldiers.
But if I say the judicial power of the United States shall be vested in one Supreme Court.
In such inferior courts as the Congress may from time to time establish, and the judges of both the Supreme and the inferior courts shall hold their office during time of good behavior. This is the next one, and they shall be compensated for their service. The judges
and shall be stated times receive for their services
a compensation, which shall not be diminished during their continuance in office.
Mic drop. Okay.
Can't stand it. Right. I can't stand it. I'm just sitting out here, hanging out with this dude. Yeah.
You know what?
Built Bar. We're going to do it. Hang on before we go anywhere. Okay. I gotta tell you guys about my guys over at Built Bar real quick. Best taste of protein bar ever. They're tasty. Protein bars that taste like a candy bar. I told you, they got 18 amazing flavors. They got the chocolate and nut flavors. They got the chocolate and nut-free flavors. Covered in 100% chocolate. Soft, easy to chew. They are healthy, guys. Listen to me. If you're health conscious, this is what you need to be using. Lose or maintain weight while indulging in an incredible treat. Bars are low calorie, low sugar, high protein, high fiber for you gym nuts like Natalie and Lisa Page. Go to BuiltBar.com. Use promo code CHAD. I spell it Chad. And you'll get 20% off your first order. Use promo code Chad for 20% off at BuiltBar.com. We'll be right back. You know, I've known a couple of people in my life like yourself, Ron, who just have the discipline to do certain things like that. And went to college with a guy named Mike Ladd. He was that way. He was my neighbor in a dormitory. And this guy, incredible steel trap memory, unreal. And just the discipline, like I said, that goes into it.
It is discipline. You know, people, I argued with people for a long time, almost 30 years now I've been doing this.
Me too.
And people will say, you too, but yeah, you in a fun way. But they'll always say to me, you have, your memory is a gift. You are gifted with a memory. And I'll always come back with, I would always say, no, I don't. Yeah. I finally accepted maybe that I do, but I will say this. My gift is not memory. It's discipline. Mm-hmm. It's that I will sit down at that table for 5 hours and memorize the Constitution, but it's not my memory's different than yours. It's just a thing of discipline. Can I say my friend Joel Priest's name before I forget, speaking of memory? He's a huge fan of yours. You're his hero. He said, if I don't say Joel Priest.
Joel Priest.
There you go. Okay.
Joel Priest. We'll never forget Joel Priest.
Let's go back to the memory.
I love it.
Okay.
Good for that. Well, tell Joel I said hello. Joel, hey, buddy.
You kind of compare that to like going to the gym or something and working out. You're just doing it mentally.
I am. And I try to focus on things that are important to me. A couple years ago, maybe 10 years ago, I decided I was going to memorize pi to 100,000 digits to get in the Guinness Book of World Records. And then about a week into it, I'm like, why the hell am I doing this? Yeah. Who cares? So then I wanted to do things that are important to me. So that's when I picked the Afghanistan wall or the Constitution. It's our country's important to me. Yeah. You know, this summer I got the American flag and I walked around downtown Fort Worth with the American flag like that. And that was considered political or negative.
That's stupid.
Because being a proud American nowadays is
how dare
so I
you?
Wanted to memorize this because of the time we're living in. Mm-hmm. It's okay to be proud to be an American.
It is. And that doesn't mean you're a racist or a nationalist or anything like that. You're an American.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that. That's why I said on yesterday's show, if you want to unify over things, let's unify over the Constitution. Let's unify over the anthem, over the flag, over the pledge. Those are the things. Those are unifiers. That's why we have them. You know,
He also loves the Chad Prather Show, so there's that.
There you go.
I do. I memorized the first 100 episodes.
That's insane, dude. When he sent me that, I was like, oh, Ron.
Right. So, Ron, how many episodes of Chad's show on YouTube now?
Well, I don't know. There's over 300, right?
Okay, but you got to what number?
I got to 100.
You memorized 100 of them. I'll show you the video.
Do you remember the one where that I was the guest?
Yeah.
I memorized the title.
He listed the title.
Oh, it's by title. Dallas Cowboys Cheerleaders.
Oh, wow. Okay. That wasn't in the first 100, I will tell you that.
Oh, okay. Man. All right.
It's okay.
But trust me, he'd know it.
I just was curious.
I will say this. On your show earlier in the week, you mentioned Al Sharpton. Well, you did a whole show dedicated to him, episode 97. Mm-hmm. You said, I miss Al Sharpton. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I know that. Yeah.
How do you stay focused when you are going to sit there for hours and hours on end? I mean, I can't sit for 5 seconds without thinking of 100 other things I need to be doing. How do you stay in that mindset of, I'm not going to leave until I know this?
I don't. So I have just the same struggles as you do, but the difference is I just don't, and I'm not saying the difference between me and you, I'm saying the difference in general is I don't give up. So I'm sitting there, I'm focused, the alarm bells go off in my head. Dude, you're not thinking about the Constitution, you're not memorizing anything, you're over here daydreaming. I'll get up, I'll go for a walk for 10 or 15 minutes, and then I'll get back. I give myself permission to have brain fog and ADD, but when I catch myself, I go for a walk, and then I resume.
Okay, so you take like a brain break. That's what my kids' teacher say, a brain break. Okay.
But, you know, I've always said the thing that works for me is read it, write it, rehearse it.
Right.
You know, if I read it, I'm seeing it. If I write it, I'm physically involved with what I'm trying to memorize. If I rehearse it, I'm hearing it.
Right.
If I say it out loud. So you're involving your senses in all of it.
You are.
And you speak a lot. You coronavirus has obviously affected you because you had to come off the road.
Right.
When you're out there doing those type of things, how does that go? I mean, what's kind of a format for what you're doing when you're in front of a live audience?
What I'll do is I will, when the group arrives, I will meet everybody, up to about 300 people. And I'll say, my name's Ron. They'll say, my name's Lisa. My name's Tom. My name's whatever. So then when I get up on stage, I'll say, if you're one of the 200 or 300 people I met, stand up. If I didn't meet you, don't stand up. It's not beat up the memory guy time.
Yeah.
300 people will stand up, and I'll jump off stage, and I'll say, Lisa, you can sit down. Karen, you can sit down. Steve, you can sit down. Brian, you can sit down. So they'll all sit down, make some jokes about, have you ever met somebody's name? And, you know, you met somebody. Then I'll memorize a number for them, and then in as fun of a way as possible, teach them how to remember, but try to entertain them while I do it.
What's the biggest place that people can find you?
Well, I got a memoryiseasy.com.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the website.
I want, because I know people are going to watch this show and they're going to want to know.
Yeah.
So I'm going to, before I forget. Right. And I love it when you sent me the video that you're like, hey, it's Ron White. Remember you met me over at Dan? And I'm like, of course I remember you.
Well, I know,
but still.
But here's the thing. I'm the memory guy. People walk up to me on the streets all the time. Hey, it's the memory guy. How you doing? You remember my name? I'm like, actually, no.
Did they get that fire?
You know, they're like, I thought you would. I met you 4 years ago. You spoke at a conference with 500 people, and you knew my name then.
That's awesome.
Dude, so I always try to be respectful. And when I see somebody that I met before I can say, I would say, hey, this is Ron. This is where we met.
Yeah.
Because nobody does that to the memory guy.
Yeah. I do know that. And I try to practice that same thing. Rodney Carrington called me the other day and we got off the phone. And then I talked to a mutual friend of ours. And she said, yeah, I told Rodney to call you. And he was like, who? Like, bastard.
That name almost hit me.
I know, right?
Dropped there.
I know. There it is. I'll drop some names. Because you don't want to be, you know, that guy who's like, I forgot this person.
You're going to have to memorize this episode now. Hopefully it'll have
my
your name.
My question.
This would be my favorite one.
Yeah. Here's my burning question. I'll start with this one. Here's my burning question. Let's go to Vegas. Can you count cards?
Yeah. Yes. Can we go?
Can
you count ballots? That's the question.
What's that?
Count the ballots.
Oh, that would be good. Yeah.
You know what? I offered in August to go door to door and memorize everybody's votes so we would not have to put up with this.
I love it. Yes.
And they laughed at me.
That's rude.
That's rude.
It would have been secure. I wouldn't have had to write anything down.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
So you mentioned lawyer. Is there a reason that you have to have a lawyer for having a good memory.
Well, are you offering to be my lawyer?
No, I
God
you
help
want
you
me for a lawyer.
No, no. I, actually, to, in all seriousness, you know, Vegas is counting cards. They don't want you counting cards at the yeah. table, which is math. You're adding one, you're subtracting one, or you're or zero. Memorizing a deck of cards is not going to help. Most likely in Vegas, they're using a six-deck shoot,
six
and it's
six.
It's not going to help. But I will say this. I was at the World Memory Championships in 2009 in London, and that's back when I used to drink. And I was sitting at the blackjack table. The World Memory Championships was next door. The hot lady next to me was hot. So so I'm talking, you know, I'm trying to impress her. She's like, why are you in London? I said, well, I used to hold the record for the fastest to memorize a deck of cards in the United States, and I'm here for the World Championships. And I kid you not, within 30 seconds, there was three very large guys standing around me. They didn't tell me to leave, but I knew it was time to leave.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Boys from over on the east side. Come with us, mate.
Oh, goodness.
Blimey! That's awesome, dude. I will never, because the last time you and I were together, we were sitting there downtown Fort Worth, and we wrote out like a list of numbers that was like 9 yeah. 10 across and 10 down or something like that, and you memorized every single one of them like that and turned it around within like 15 seconds and regurgitated all of them.
And that's a good a memory for you, because that was late at night and a year ago.
yeah,
you remember that.
That's a lot
so
of
that's
fun,
impressive
dude. That was a lot of fun. Y'all hang tight, we'll be right back. So when you memorize the first 100 episodes of this show, in a nutshell, how do you do that?
So in essence, I use a technique known as the mind palace or the memory palace, where I would look at this room and I would number the guitar, the couch, and I'd number 10 spots in this room. Then I take the first episode that I want to remember, agenda driven, and I create a picture for the word agenda, and I will see an agenda on that first location. And then the next episode y'all had was butter boy baby, your baby, you know.
Yeah.
So on the next one, I see on the next piece of furniture, I see a baby covered in butter, and it's a baby boy. So in essence, I'm visualizing stuff just like you turn numbers into pictures, and then I place them in locations around a room. So the Constitution, I used the Stockyards in downtown Fort Worth. You know, I went through all the bars. So the Constitution is in all the bars in downtown Fort Worth is where it is.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And that's a dude who ain't drinking either.
Crazy.
Make sure you guys are following Ron on Instagram, at BrainAthlete.
BrainAthlete.
And check him out online. Have him at one of your events. This guy, he likes to work. What you got, Steve?
Episode 65.
Who's the boss?
There you go.
Oh,
who's the boss?
Yeah, Tony.
Who's the boss?
Glenn Beck.
Oh, Glenn Beck. Yeah, I remember that episode. We got to have Glenn back on here very soon, by the way. Thanks for coming on, brother.
Oh, thank you.
And always a pleasure, and you're always welcome here. We're going to have some fun in the days ahead with it as well. Impressive.
Thank you.
Go to watchchad.com. It's where all the fun stuff is. And no shows this weekend, Steve. I'm headed to Georgia. We're going to see about this voting thing going on in Georgia.
Fix and, it. Count those ballots.
Lisa
I guess
Page
I'm going to pick up cans.
You going to pick up some cans?
Something.
I hope so.
Got to work.
Something. We love y'all. Hot News, Natalie. We love y'all. God bless. We'll talk to you next time. Bye.